Yeah, yeah. I gotta go live. I'm an adult. Stone since the 70s, and a nerd for life. And I'm half a person. That's right, person. Fun with our and Joe Wentz is having a birthday jam at the same time. Hopefully you see it. I'm gonna keep that on. Because you know, if I didn't go live because someone else I knew was live, I'd never do it. You get that, don't you? For sure. Oh, yeah, yeah. Joe Wentz rock. I want a t-shirt from one of them. Joe Wentz. Jim Stafford brought it. Hey, Sean, how you doing? Yeah, I cut my finger real bad. Of course, I've kind of used that as an excuse not to go home. But I decided I was going to go ahead and go live tonight. And then Joe, I looked up and Joe's having a birthday jam. Oh, and it looks like I bought myself some Frank had a video here a few days ago, or maybe it was one of some old one that popped up in my watch, where he did some transfers for t-shirts, where you just put it on your printer and you get an iron and you can transfer. But he like spent a whole bunch of time cutting it out because you're supposed to cut them out. So, and then I got the bright idea. I kind of made some practice stickers. These are just labels. Well, I think I put the label I put on your shirt, I just printed these stickers up. And I haven't really airbrushed in almost a week. I did a little bit on when you're gonna get to me. I did a little bit of airbrush on Swede stream here recently. And I don't know how much airbrushing I'm really going to do. I'm probably going to be doing more just checking to see if my airbrushes are working. Oh, and what I cut my finger on, I don't know if you saw that stream. That was pretty, pretty much stuff up. But yeah, I cut my I bled all over. It was true. Yeah, I haven't been going live regularly, but I was trying to get to dig up my old live stream. Set up this little microphone. face. I didn't do any sort of mic check other than I know this one worked. Let me go ahead and flip this mic. I did a little adjustment. I went back when I was trying to work on the time-lapse stuff. I noticed that there's like some wishy-washy sound going on all the time with this through the this cordless one. Let's see if it connects. Okay. It should have connected. Hey Jim, how you doing tonight, man? Oh. Well, I guess that's a good place to put it right there. I can connect it to the shirt. Oh, but I have to turn it on. Muted it. Yeah, that's right. I muted it on this on my audio mix. There we go. Be able to turn it on the audio mix. Good. And it looks like I got rid of most of the swishy stuff. And then I can just
hit the mute button on that one, so I don't have the funky echo. Hopefully, I got a good mix on. I don't know for sure. I don't know what I'm going to do. I just wanted to show off these little things I did. This is what I was doing. I was cutting circles. I was cutting circles when I cut my finger with that. That is a circular cutter. And I've gone and I don't know if I actually ordered it yet, but yeah, and I've painted some stuff. Here is one of my... Here's one of my paper towel masterpieces. I don't know if I showed these off or not. I don't think I've actually had a live stream since I cut my finger. Hopefully YouTube won't shut me down since I'm like simulcasting Joe Wentz in the background. I think I turned him down enough. How loud is Joe Wentz? Let me know if he's, it needs to be like way off in the distance. The funky echo. Oh yeah, it does. Oh, that's cool. I lurk most of the time. I'm not really doing anything significant. But I did actually put one of these on one of these wooden things, thinking that I might paint something on it. I don't know. I haven't had my airbrushes out in like a week, so basically, all I'm planning on doing is cleaning them up. And I've heard talk from both, and so it's like I haven't painted with this in a week. So I'm just gonna see if I can't shake it up a little bit and just see how it'll paint, if it'll paint and how it paints. Because basically the difference between these master airbrushes and the ones that are a little more expensive than that is just, there's like a seal in here, like a Teflon or a silicone seal that like seals the front from the back. And these masters, that seal wears out real fast. So they start out like really good airbrushes, but they wear out real fast. And because both of the guys that I kind of watch and I'm, like I've joined their channels, both of them gave fairly decent reviews of them, But, you know, in looking back now, because they did their reviews, now that they've actually used them a little bit. So, yeah, it's probably not a good, I'm not really getting anything out of this, so. I'm just going to clean this airbrush. Because even if I do get something, it's probably not going to be much. Yeah. So it could be the paint and it could be the airbrush. Let me double check this little seal here to make sure that this is clear. Okay, so I'm just going to clean this one out. And that's basically all I was going to do. I mean, I should have done, this isn't a show. There's really no show in me cleaning these out. Because basically all I'm doing is just running water through them. A little bit of water. And a little bit of thinner. And get them back into working order so I can get busy painting some stuff. I got some good ideas too. Oh, and since I'm always so nervous about doing checks, I'm actually going to order some of the transfer stuff. So if there's some text I really want to do, I can just use those little transfers because I've got the heat press. Or make some stencils. That was the other alternative. Brush is fairly clean. Sucking water and sucking through the center. So let's see if this is my red. Let's see if this red is going to spray any paint for me. I was gonna do one of those found records. I got it on my playlist though. So what is the name of it? What is the name of the one that I was going to do? I can't remember. I listened to the whole thing. Usually I only listen to a little bit of it. The Dirty Art Club. Yeah, there's this band called Dirty Art Club I was listening to that I thought sounded pretty good. Well, this one's working fairly good, right? From even having set for so long. Oh yeah, and Mike's brush, he says don't thin your paint. So I need to find some happy medium in there. And he talked about using a much lower air pressure. So, I mean, it works for him. So I'm going to find some happy medium between the two techniques. And then find some, because I mean, I can obviously tell that some of these master airbrushes are made better than others. you can tell that there's just inconsistent workmanship. Now that's working okay, but compared to the, I'm gonna go ahead and clean it up out of this color, because I want it to work more like the my new one. I haven't gotten to a new one yet. I think kind of my goal tonight is to just basically see which ones will actually paint for me, and then see which ones will actually squirt some paint out. I got a few ideas of what I want to do, but yeah. Yeah, I mean, this one looks like it has a nice flow, but just the difference between the flow of, look at this. This is the fine one. This is the one with the 0.3 needle on it. I think. Yeah, because that's the one that I put this little piece of tape on. For some reason, this one is always working better than the 0.5s, which is the standard needle size. I don't quite understand why. Yeah, that particular airbrush is working pretty doggone good. I'd see how this blue is working. Funky Echo would make a good name of a band. The Funky Echoes. Oh, good. Yeah. Even after a week of just sitting there with nothing, no activity, I just shook it up a little bit and look at that. Doing good. I especially like it when I can go from a little fine line to a thick line. If I can do that, if I can make these like little sweeping lines, it makes me really happy. Oh, look. Oh, look at that, booby clouds. But I'm still, let's see, I'm not gonna clean this one yet. I'm gonna hang on to a few colors, because if my black's working pretty good, once I get down to the black, I'm gonna actually paint some. If there's anybody still hanging out, you never know. Well, and really when it comes down to it, it's just that's what I want to see.
Is Rocker Pat in the house? Rocker Pat, oh. German Butcher, what's up, Ralph? Thanks, Ralph.
Looks like it's working. Yeah, it's working. Okay. not as good as I'd like it to. But considering it's just kind of been sitting there doing nothing, and this is my raspberry. Oh, raspberry looks like it's working good too. Working okay. That one needs to be cleaned out. Oh, leave the air on it. I just need to run a bunch of water. Yeah, I know on my other channel I was like, oh yeah. Having issues just running some water through that one. What's going on? Different water. Oh, my new airbrushes. They were all leaking air on the quick release. I just ended up just putting some Teflon tape on it, and it sealed them all up pretty good. I've hardly even used them. The little bit that I have used them, I really like them. I did the black and the white and the black and white shit. That fell there.
Want some more? Do you want some more? Let me see it in the chat. Come on, man. Let's get that chat fucking moving. Come on.
What is it? Is it Monday? Yeah, it's Monday. Everybody's getting their vaccine, so everybody's getting the hell out of Dodge, getting out of the house. I'm fixing to get the hell out of the house, too. I'm looking to get me a vehicle. I think I'm going to get myself like an SUV or something. Hey, Derby Jack. Oh, I was just digging through stuff the other day. And yeah, I'm like so uncertain about lettering and stuff. But there was like a little space. There was a quick little spell there. Here we go. Yeah, when I was feeling pretty confident about doing people's lettering. I don't know, it's weird, it kind of comes and goes. Yeah, what all did I do? I did a this old stoner's, and then a derby jack, and then I did a stoned again, and then I did the funeral host. Yeah, there's a few scrolls of paper towels around here where I was just trying to practice with people's names and stuff. It's really amazing how time kind of gets away from you when you're doing this sort of thing. Hey, Mark. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, some big old huge scrolls with people's names on them and different things. I mean, I don't do the big paper towel scrolls like I was doing them, but I mean, I'm calling them masterpieces. May as well. They're paper towel masterpieces. They're just going to disintegrate in a few years easily. You know, it's like temporary art, I guess. And I'm not really painting anything. All I'm doing tonight is just like cleaning my airbrushes, seeing if they actually still work after they've been sitting here for so long. I was painting some clouds that look like alien eyes or boobies. I'm not sure which. It just depends upon where your head is when you're looking at them. And the green seems to be working okay. But not the way that I really want it to be working. Oh yeah, and it's already clogged up, so I need to clean this one too. I'll check with my little vent hole here to see if it's gonna work. Yeah. Man, Mark's getting to be quite the skateboard enthusiast. Oh, and skateboarder. What do they call you now? Skate dad. Yeah, this one I need to just clean up. Yeah, let me see if it'll clean up reasonably deep. And these are all the masters. And the masters, it just in the end, they just turn out to be like super inconsistent. And that little seal, the Teflon seal between the body and the air is what's, that's where I've had a whole bunch of them that like wore out right away. It didn't last very long at all. And then some of them that have done real good. So that's the problem. They're cheap airbrushes. So you kind of, in the end, you get what you pay for. They're a great starter brush, but they're not going to last very long under a lot of wear and tear. I'll be able to compare them, you know, here in a couple of months with the no-names that I bought, because I'm going to kind of transition over to the no-names and then just use these masters just to expand my color where I don't really need to be drawing lines. Maybe for lines, I don't know. But I definitely like having a whole bunch of different colors set up all at the same time. Okay, so this one's... But having been sitting for so long now, I figured probably I should clean them up. I should have cleaned them up before the show, but hell. Hey! Hey, Space Gallery. Oh, yeah, yeah. I've kind of been playing a lot of games, too. Oh, and soon I'm gonna get me a vehicle. I'm going to get an SUV and set it up like my daughter's. I actually was able to go over to my daughter's the other day. It was pretty cool. And she's got her... So I went in with my ex and we got her a box for the top of her car. And she likes to go camping, and she has pets. So I went in on that and also got her like seat covers for her pets. She's real particular too, about trying to, I mean, it's a nice car, nice paint job and stuff, which is kind of crazy because she goes up in the mountains with it. But anyway, it's like a little SUV, and she's got it set up to where she can just sleep in the back. She was joking, saying that the bed in the back of her SUV is more comfortable than my bed. And well, she's probably right. And she was showing me how she has it all set up to where the dogs can be in there and not, and get in and out of the car without scratching it. It was pretty awesome. So I got to thinking, well, maybe I should do that. And then if I ever actually go and visit someone, well, I can just be like, what, the nomads, where they just sleep in the back of their, well, it's like having your little van or whatever, you know. Maybe I'll do that. Who knows? I thought it was a great idea because the little truck I have, oh man, I was disappointed with it almost instantly. But I've got my money's worth out of it. I don't drive that often, but I definitely want to get something that I can actually track, go somewhere in. My son's trying to convince me that it's actually cheaper and easier to just fly and use Ubers. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. Okay, now here's a... I don't know exactly what size needle this is, but this is some black in a master. Black, I think this is... I know it's not a 0.5. And it's... Yeah, it's leaking air. I'm not even going to mess with that one. I'll just tear up. Now! I got a lot of airbrushes. I got a lot of damn airbrushes. Oh, hey, Finite World. Hey, Streamlabs, how you been? I haven't seen you in a while. Okay, so this is one of my new ones. This is one of the no names, and this is just the Createx black right out of the bottle. I've just got one of those siphon tubes that will fit right down in it. I know I've got a marble, I've got a little ball bearing down in there, but I can't hear it shaking. But I should have more than enough air pressure. According to Mike's brush, I got way more than I need. I think I'm running around 50 or 60 pounds. And he made an interesting point. He said that when you run it high, granted, you're able to get a lot of paint out, you can actually put a lot of paint on your shirt. Oh yeah, this is great. Let's see, is it great or did I speak too soon? I may have spoke too soon. It's just straight up black right out of the bottle. Like it's working pretty good. See if I can draw something with this. Oh, I know what I want to do. Okay. Let me just...
Oh yeah. I like this airbrush. This is just the paint straight out of the bottle, and I hadn't done anything to it since last week.
Well, since I painted that skull, let's see if I can do another one of those skulls. Oh, there's my reference. This is a skull design that I did pen and ink, in the late 70s or early 80s, I believe. I really like the design. I made like a stencil of a cow skull, but I didn't like the way that the stencil came out. And I'm liking the way this is coming out much better. The few that I've done of this one, just looking at just a photocopy of the original drawing that I did.
Come on, baby, salute.
Getting kind of, I'm losing my sharpness. What's going on there?
But these are different tips, so I don't want to get them mixed up with the old guard.
Don't want to get the new guards mixed up with the old guards. Okay, where am I? Okay, here I am. Yeah, I'm not able to get the fine line that I'm wanting, but that just may be the nature of the airbrushes that I'm using. I may have to just learn how to adjust. The other thing that I decided that it needs it. Oh yeah, I just recently added it since I decided to start doing this little design again.
Thank you so much for being here. I had a great time. Thank you so much.
Some barbed wire.
I spent, man. Thank you very much, everybody.
I haven't quite figured out, got my barbed wire figured out, but let's see. You have a something like that. One that goes up and one that goes down. There it is. That's more of the barbed wire look. And then what else do I always put, like putting this? Oh, I forgot this other horn. Where's this horn? There we go. And how else do I do it? Oh, yeah. I make like a mountain range in the background here. Oh, and that's perfect. I left some of this blue here. I left this blue
here. Oh yeah, because I like to use blue for my skull. Let's see, is the blue working? It was a minute ago. Oh yeah, working just about right. Not too, I would be frustrated with it if I was trying to cover a large area. But since I'm just kind of like doing some little highlights on there, that works good. And that's mountain. Oh yeah, that's what this is. This is mountain. I'll try and make this purple if I can. Oh yeah, I got some pink over here. And yellow, okay. Let's see, some sky, a little bit of sky. Here, see if I can get the blue to actually... put out some, there we go. I have to force it to put out some volume, you know. And, I don't have any orange. I do have yellow, so what am I going to do here? I think what I'll do here is I will make this part of the sky yellow. Yeah. Oh, it sounds like Joe's done with his birthday jam. Okay, and now I already cleaned that up. Let's see if this pink will work. Let me see if this pink will work. Some hot pink, hot fluorescent pink. Later, Space Gallery. Oh yeah, it seems like it's working great. So I'm just trying to give it like this purple sky. And then bring the pink into the top of the clouds, yeah. And give it kind of a, and actually I think I will, my pink's working so good, I think I'm just going to swap over and see if this orange is going to work. If this orange is going to work, well then, if I can get this orange to work, it may have been the paint though, because yeah, it must have been the paint. Is it the paint? Yeah, it's the paint because the pink was working fine. Okay, so that was a mistake. Let me see if I can get the pink to work going back, and hopefully the orange didn't. Yeah, the pink is still working. Okay, I'll put a little pink on this pole here because I'm going to come back with some brown. If my brown's working, I hope the brown's working. If the brown's working, I'll finish it up real quick. Oh, I didn't even pull out the white. I could put some white highlights in there to make it pop. Oh, yeah, yeah. Make it pop. Oh. Dropped it. Hang on. Maybe tomorrow I'll actually get some paint ready. Oh yeah, there we go. And just kind of a I got a bunch of airbrushes, other airbrushes I could pull out with. Let me see. Some orange would have looked good on there, but I didn't really get any orange. Let's see. Oh, that's what I was saying. Some white. Let's see if I can actually get my white to work. Oh, and actually, I could be on this other. Should have been up here close so that you can really see what I'm painting there. That's how I should. That's the camera I should have had on there. Let's see if the white's going to work for me. Oh. Yeah, and that was the reason, you know, it's just. Oh, that would look good. Some like little speckles, some sort of texture. That's what it needs. A little bit of texture. What kind of texture would look good? This is kind of like camo texture. Let me see. Let me see if a little bit of this down. Oh no. There's all my. I think just a little bit of this. If I just do it this subtly. It's a little bit of subtle. Yeah. Oh yeah, that was fun. I'm glad I decided to go live. I really am. Got to see what airbrushes were working. Get my paint all kind of tuned in there. Hey, Swedes! Oh yeah, yeah. I'm trying to see if I still got my little airbrush chops, and I like my little design there. The spirit skulls is what I call that. It's two skulls on a fence post. Oh yeah, yeah. Well, I think I'm done for the night. It was fun. I got to listen to Joe Wentz in the background. Hopefully, YouTube doesn't give me crap about that. I got to ramble on about how I messed up my finger and about these airbrushes, kind of like my a few months after all the raving, I kind of went overboard buying those master airbrushes. But they are what they are. They're good, cheap airbrushes, but they don't hold up, and they're inconsistent. I bought enough of them to where I can actually see the difference in the craftsmanship between different airbrushes. Out of like 10 of them that I bought, I'd say 5 or 6 of them are actually good, and 2 of them crapped out like day one. And it was been driving me crazy to figure out what the problem was, and I found out just a few days ago that it's the little seal in there, that they have like these really cheap seals that wear out. Hey, Bull! Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, no, no. My daughter wanted me to do tattoos, but no way will I ever do tattoos. I can't imagine somebody wanting to put something like that on their body. And I, for sure, could not do it myself. I've had a few people say that. No way. I could never do that. Takes too much fine precision. I'll have to show you the photos of my daughter's tattoos. She paid like, I don't know, close to $2,500 for this. Oh, man. She got a really, really good artist to do it. And it took 3 6-hour sessions, I believe. And part of it is like a tribute to her. Well, 2 tributes to her cousins that have both died. It has a whole lot of meaning, and it's just, oh, man. I'm calling it a night. Thank you guys for coming and hanging out with me. I actually managed to paint one of my little spirit skulls on that backing. That's some kind of cool backing too. What is it? This is it. It's of course it's going to have those in it. I don't know if I can actually put it on one of these rings. The little rings are too small. It would look funky on the little ring. But I have a big ring here. But would probably look pretty cool. I know I got another big. Oh, here it is. I'm not sure. I could put it in such a way, yeah, that would look kind of cool on a big ring. Can you just see that? That might work on a big ring. We'll see. I'll see if I can. But yeah, this cloth is just not quite big enough for the big ring. The paper towels they work on for sure. You guys have a great night. Oh, I guess I should leave it up there. Here's the one that I did on the paper towel. This one came out really good too. I got a bunch of shit in here. Oh boy. There I go, starting to ramble. I did know that I got some cool ideas though. I've got these tubes. I realized I wasn't sure why I bought these tubes. Part of the reason I bought this tube was to make a holder. You see the little X's? I drill a hole in there, a big hole, and my airbrushes fit in there like I've got down there on that other holder. Only this one will hold more and it's deeper. So But I realized that I can send pictures in these things. So, and I was looking at some of these drawings and things that I was practicing on. It's like this right here will fit in one of these tubes to mail. And actually, not only that, but if I get the wild hair to do a big one again, where did I put that paper? I've got this giant paper that will fit in there too. I'm all like going, what? Here's one that I painted on already. Oh, I just knocked something down. I've got a blank one of these somewhere. But yeah, one of these, you can't really see how big this is. What is it? This is 2 feet by 4 feet. It's like I have a piece of paper that's 2 feet by 4 feet that will fit, that will roll up in one of these tubes. I'm kind of curious to see if I can't come up with a cool idea to actually airbrush on it. But that's enough for tonight's show. I'm this old stoner. I've had a good time. I hope you've had a good time. I'll be back again someday. You never know when. But I'll have fun. You can count on that.
Intestinal distress is common during a cardiac event.
I just want to hear the doctor say that Jerry had a fart attack. Is that too much to ask?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Have fun with art. And remember, the only rule of Fart Club is you gotta think farts are funny. Oh, yeah, yeah.